There's a big difference between being a popular hot ass gospel and being a real fag. See, real fags suck dick. Now, some of y'all popular hot ass gospel suck dick too, but you may not be a fag. I'm listening. Continue. Cause see, Mo, he don't suck dick or none.
But he's a PhD.
He is definitely a fag. I get on the telephone and I calls that Mo, and I'd be like, "Sha." Mo be like, "What?"
Ready to gossip.
I'll be like, "Sha." Mo be like, "What?" Bitch, what?
Is that what he says?
He like, "What?"
Is I don't say child.
I baby, I
child.
Get on the phone with G. I be like, "G." Be like, "What?" Be like, "G."
I say all the time.
I be like, "Bitch."
Men, straight men gossip more than women and fags.
Baby.
F-A-Gs.
Ooh, let me tell you something. Sha. So I know it won't be, which I'm talking about the volume low. Mo, turn the fan down a little bit. We had to put it, it's, you know, we got all these lights in here. It's hot in here. Open that door. We better open that door. Cold tea.
You can get this shirt on my website, CraigTheWriterStewart.com.
Girl, you rushed down there, honey, and pulled that shirt together.
Sure did. Them children told me I wasn't famous. I'm like, you're right, I'm not. But I can make a couple dollars off of it.
Baby, you had them went down there. You rushed and snagged that shirt together. Baby.
Sure did. After same day.
After the internet had been dragging me.
Girl, they dragged me too, girl. Girl, I got a few skins on my knees,
girl,
too.
I mean, you know, here's the gag. They had drugged me. I bet you know I got skin. You may have some on your knees. I have them on my knees, my back, my side. They have it. They had, and they are still in the current moment dragging me.
Girl, they thought that the fags had broke up.
Girl, they had said that. Girl, listen.
They thought the fags had broke
let me,
up.
Let me let y'all know something.
Girl, you all don't have that much power.
At all. Just like they're trying to reach over to the 100 tell them children to fire me from all the jobs that I got. Bitch, I work for me.
Girl, like I told you the other day, girl, their arms don't reach far enough from that cubicle to get to the rooms that you are in, girl.
Girl, some of them ain't even in the cubicle. They land on the sofa, honey, waiting on the man to come home while they boiling hot dogs.
Girl, you giving them credit for having sofas, girl.
Oh,
they ain't even got futons.
Girl,
some of them children ain't got a liner for their shower, bitch. They ain't got a shower curtain.
Well, we want to be the first people to say that if there's any Netta and Charles news that comes up in the media, we will not be talking about
that. We will not be talking about the icons, not because we can't, but because we don't want to.
Yes, correct. So please, for those people that want to send that stuff in and want to and the things. We're not talking about those people. Craig have received his 10 lashings. I've received my 15, and my knees have been drug off. And I'm not with any of that, okay? I'm over it. It's done. It doesn't happen. Is that all? We wouldn't be the fags if we wouldn't address popular hot ass gossip because we are popular hot ass gossip.
Right. But you know, like we said at City Winery, no one cared when I talked about Billy, what's his name? Porter.
Uh-huh.
No one cared when we talked about Gerard Carmichael.
Uh-huh.
No one cared when we talked about Don Lemon or any other black men who date white guys. No one cared when we talked about these people. Is it bullying when those people on the internet come after you week after week?
Yes, it is. But no one sees
that. No one calls it bullying.
Well, because it's women doing it. Mm. And women have the right to do that. And I don't have the right to respond. Right. This is hence we have the show. The hetero supremacy.
Wait, would you explain that for
us? Well, the hetero supremacy means heterosexual people have gotten to this space. And, you know, it took me a moment because I was like, I really, really, really want to address this on the show? Mm-hmm. Because, you know, I try to, you know, appease the fans. But then I was like, I used to go live and there were 10 people. And then there were 15.
Right.
And then there were 20.
Right.
And then there were 2,000,
right.
And then there were 5,000, and then so on and so forth.
Right.
And ever since I've been live in my entirety of my career, I've been unapologetically me. Mm-hmm. I've been authentically me.
Right.
And because I've been those things, I have been able to occupy spaces because I've been exactly who I am.
Right.
Right?
Right.
Okay. So I said, was I going to touch it? It's touched. So let's go there. So I think. And I want to try to use some HSBC lingo.
Okay, I'm here to help.
Thank you. You did go to school for both of us. Thanks.
Just say it. Just let them use you.
He is. They are. They and them gonna use me.
Okay.
You know God is androgynous.
Uh-huh.
I want y'all to know that.
Mm-hmm.
That God is a spirit. There's no dick or no pussy.
Oh.
Because he don't need to reproduce. All he needs to do is speak, and it was. And it shall be.
and forevermore.
I don't know if I'm going to lose a lot of women followers and things like that or whatever, or heterosexual followers or whatever, but at this point in my life and in my career, I really am past the point of caring about appeasing and all this stuff. I personally think that people feel, and it took me a second for me to sit down and like really, really think about this. I think that the reason why everybody's been so up in arms and everybody is so ready for America to get back great again and to get back into these spaces where people are allowed to demean, disrespect, and completely disregard human life because they don't agree with their with people's gender identity, sexual orientation, you know, who they're attracted to, whatever, because they're not in total agreement with that. And they have these moral clauses, mm-hmm, right? Mm-hmm. So I've watched how this works. And I used to say things like, well, as a part of the homosexual community and mm-hmm. transsexual community, whatever, the Rainbow Coalition community, Libiquita, I used to be on the fence at times, having a lot of heteronormative ideas being passed down to me from my mm-hmm. from my parents, like, well, why the gays got to do this, and why they got to be so? Why, when I come to think about it, the reason why we have to be a protected class of people or protected group of people is because even hate people that hate each other will bond together mm-hmm. to erase us, to right. eradicate our presence,
right.
And hence why we have so many people on the bandwagon. If you ask a person, because we were on live the other night with Monique Slaughter, mm-hmm. if you ask a person, what are their main reasons why they're voting for Trump? A lot of them, the top of the rhetoric is I don't know if they've got him like he's some holy man or whatever. Mm-hmm. And he is for good Christian moral values. And I'm like, wow. And anything that has good Christian moral values has nothing to do with the Libiquita community.
At all.
So people find it deep within themselves. Okay. Mm-hmm. I've talked about this separately. I'd like to talk about this with you. I've been reading for the past couple. I've been reading Trashy mm-hmm. and Magilla. Mm-hmm. I've been reading those two women who have been antagonizing me. They've been antagonizing me. They've been, you know, going at me like just on a constant basis, mm-hmm. you know. And the moment that I respond, mm-hmm. I become misogynistic. I become anti-Black. I become a Black woman, you know, all these things. Mm-hmm. And I sat with it for a moment. And I was like, well, no one remembers that these people hit me first. Mm-hmm. Well, no one even cares. I saw so many women writing in other comment sections, I don't care what they did. I'm siding with them because they're women. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, wow.
Mm-hmm. That's like I'm saying I'm siding with a person just because they're Black.
Just because they're, so they can do the most heinous shit.
Right.
But just because they are Black or just because they are women, mm-hmm. I'm siding with them because mm-hmm. I'm a female and I'm siding with this person. No, I don't care what she's done to other people. Mm-hmm. I don't care what they've done. I don't care what they're currently doing mm-hmm. to people. I don't care at all. As long as they're doing it to you because you're a faggot. Mm-hmm. You're a homosexual. You are a man in a wig. You are here on this earth. You are trying to infiltrate the space. You are making me uncomfortable because you're here. I'm angry because you're here. You are not what I am. You want to be me. You have pussy envy. You are upset with me because I am real and you are not. All of the long list. Mm-hmm. But have yet to check the individuals who got us here in the first place. Mm-hmm. Woman yeah. of God. Mm. Hold on. Woman of God. Mm. You have every right to decimate that homosexual. You have every right to do any dark, ill things to that gay. Now, I'm going to overlook all the things that you've done to Cardi B. I'm going to overlook all the things you've done to Kenya Moore. I'm going to overlook all the things you've done to Claudia Jordan. I'm going to look overlook all the things that you've done to other Black women because you are antagonizing and you are attempting to hurt this person. Mm-hmm. I don't care because you dox them. Mm-hmm. That doesn't matter to me. Let somebody pull up to their house and shoot and kill them. They should be dead. Mm-hmm. This is what this sounds like to me. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I'd like for you all to know that this is what this sounds like to me. I don't care what happens to them. Let them die. One less faggot to worry about. And then when I slide up into defending myself, mm-hmm. I have to have parameters.
Right.
Parameters.
You can't go too far.
I have to have parameters in which, oh my, now I have to be concerned about, oh, their children are innocent. No, their children are an extension of them, mm-hmm. because they're currently teaching their children right now to be the same people that they are.
The same way that racists.
So fuck your kids. Mm. You shouldn't talk about their traumas, but yet they can say you have AIDS. Mm-hmm. So what if I had AIDS? Let's talk about what if I had AIDS? What if? What if I had AIDS and that was a trauma for me?
Right.
Mm-hmm. Where's the mercy? Mm-hmm. Here we go. Like I'm pointing this out. Let's talk about Craig. Help me here. Stop me when I'm wrong.
Okay. No. You're not wrong. You're not wrong. Go ahead.
Stop me when I'm wrong. Let's talk about when we get here to this space, and my mother, who's a black woman, who has been handicapped because she was hurt on her job.
Right.
That's a sweet spot for me.
Right.
Let's talk about the constant digs at that to get me riled up. Mm-hmm. Because that age shit don't bother me. Mm-hmm.
Because of all of the things that we talk about over here, we never talk about any of those people.
Correct.
Ever.
So let's talk about how they do these things to get me riled up. And then when mm-hmm. I do, and I go, and then I hit you by, well, your mama got, you got fucked in your ass by your mama's boyfriend. You talk about all the bodies that I done had. You can't wipe that body off of you that your mama's nigga gave you mm-hmm. while she was laid up smoking crack. You mm-hmm. can't wipe that body off of you.
Hold on.
Allegedly. Mm-hmm. Out of all the bodies of my whore body got, I know one body I ain't got, and that's my mama's nigga while she was smoking crack. I know that. Oh my God, that's too low. Oh, that's too low.
But the thing that's so interesting to me, though, is, and we've talked about this behind the scenes, too, it's like there are so many black content creators or vloggers or whatever you want to call them who spend their entire existence demeaning and trying to weigh down black folks, stress black folks out. Like, we don't even think about, like, the mental shit that shit does to people. You know what I'm saying? Like, that one particular blogger that you're talking about, mm-hmm. always talking about the Housewives of Atlanta.
Yeah.
All the slander, all of the self-hate. Like, these are black people tearing other black people down. It's one thing for me to sit over here and laugh and joke about a lawnmower and shit like that, but to literally try to dig up people's address, show their finances and all those kinds of things, that's a whole different level. That's something else. And it's just like, are these the same kind of black people that hate other black people?
Yes. It's usually those black women who have this thing about, I hate black women, are projecting what they feel about other black yeah. women onto me. Yeah. And it's because I occupy spaces that black women occupy. I've never once proclaimed to be a black woman. I proclaim to be a black trans woman.
Right.
I've never proclaimed to be a black female. Right. I cannot be a female because I was not birthed. I didn't come through the vaginal channel as a female, so I can't be that. So right. I've acknowledged all of these things. And stuff like that. So my question to you, Craig, mm-hmm. do you think, as my friend, mm-hmm. that I've went too far on any of those women?
No, I don't think that you've gone too far. Now, you've said some things that I wouldn't have said, but I don't think that it's necessarily too far because, again, these are people, and I know some of you are like, well, how is that different from you talking about the icons? But what I'm saying is, those were things that came up in popular culture. These are the people that are coming after you, putting your passport out. They're talking about your mom. You know what I mean? They're trying to use your dead name. They're, you know, making fun of you being trans.
Let's play devil's advocate on their behalf. Here's the thing. I was born male. So are they saying something that's not true?
No, but like, I really, now that's cyberbullying. That is cyberbullying.
Okay.
And you know, I've said before, like I've said to you, like, I really think that what, because, and I'm only going to say this now because I've heard that Tasha K has had my name in her mouth.
Yeah, viciously.
Really? Mm-hmm. Now, see, I haven't seen it because I don't watch her shit. But she follows me and she subscribed to me.
Right.
But here's the thing. What I have said to you privately, and I'm going to say now, and maybe this will find its way over to Cardi B. Maybe your team hasn't thought of this yet. I think that Cardi B's law team needs to go after that bitch's YouTube channel. They need to go after, they need to do a cease and desist from her entire channel. Fuck that bitch up in her wallet, mm-hmm. in her purse, so then she has no income. I've been saying that to you for months now. That's right. What they really need to do. Or Kevin Hart's people need to go over there and tap on YouTube's channel and say, bring that shit down.
Well, you know, I watch a few people.
Because she's using that channel as a weapon.
Yes, I watched a few people talk about, you know, how she demonetized her channel and all this. I watched a few things, you know, and how she frauded the bankruptcy court and, uh-huh. you know, told lies into perjury and all that type of stuff. You know, mm-hmm. I watched those things. I seen the things or whatever.
Right.
What I saw the most, though, is people overlooking all of these things and she tried to do this sympathy thing where she was on there like, well, let me explain what happened. My mom was she was trying to over that all this stuff, you know, trying to rally the women up to be like, that Madison is a monster. He is a monster. He's mm-hmm. evil. He used your trauma. And it's like you totally don't see the things that these people have done to me. It's not like I don't meet these women to their door,
right?
And come at their door, starting inciting things with them. That's right. Not what I do.
Right.
That's not what we. And usually, right. as gays, that's not what we do. Right. We're usually in a response state
mm-hmm.
when it comes down to stuff.
Well, that's why most of us have such quick tongues too. You know, growing up as a fag, you know, you had to be on your toes because the first thing somebody was going to say, "Oh, you fag, you sissy, you punk." So you were always ready. You already had your. That's why we have such wicked tongues.
Yeah,
it's years of training.
Well, it's years of being trained by them,
right? And being
that have done vicious and, you know, malicious things. You know,
right?
Because I think that doxing someone is very malicious.
It really is,
because you're not doing that in a space of trying to, like, you're not doing that in a space of trying to gender reveal.
Oh, I would have sued them.
Well, there were boundaries that they because they know how to play, but I went after that manager for delivering mm-hmm. the things, you know. Mm-hmm. But there's boundaries in which they were trying to play within, like, you know, marking it out. But mm-hmm. they know what they were doing with because you a person that owns things, you usually have things in your name, and people look up things that's in your name, and this is how they find the addresses and all. People know how this stuff works, right. and that usually be their reasons for doing these things, because, you know, my life isn't worth mm-hmm. anything because I'm a fag,
mm-hmm.
and I'm talking about a fag,
right?
So this is why I have no mercy, and I'm not ever in any state or any mind well-being going to ever have any mercy any mercy for them, for their children, for their feelings, for any of abuse or any of things uh-huh. that they've suffered. I truly despise them just on the same level that they do me.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that I have every right to do that.
Mm-hmm. Right. Well, I'm not going to sit and argue with them.
No, I'm not. But I'm just saying, I'm talking about hetero supremacy. And
correct.
Again,
it ties into that.
We're back to the place of, well, I'm straight. Or I'm heterosexual, and I just feel like that there are parameters that in which you homosexuals, you fact need to stay within. You need to bow down to us,
because
that's what it is.
Yeah.
You need to bow down to us because you are unimportant.
Mm-hmm.
God does not like you.
Mm-hmm.
Let's start there. God does not like you. God doesn't like you. So because God doesn't like you, I have the right to do anything malicious to you. Anything.
Well, here's the thing. Being gay or queer, let me just say queer. Being queer doesn't put you on the wrong side with God. It just doesn't. That's first. Second, that same rhetoric, you can interchange that with racism.
But they don't see that.
Right. That's why I say all the time. There are so many parallels.
Come on. Let's do it.
and racism.
This is why I have you here in this intellectual conversation. Right? Let's break it down. Can you show the parallels for us, please?
There are many parallels. And so in the same way that there were white people who didn't want to see black folks on TV, why do we got to keep seeing these niggas on TV? You think that there weren't white people back in the day when black folks first started being introduced on commercials and TV shows? Why is it that it took so many years for a black woman to be the leading star of a television show? Like, there was Julia with Diane Carroll. And then many, many, many years went by. And I think the next time we saw that was Kerry Washington with Scandal. I could be wrong, but it was many, many years later. And so the same way that there were white people who didn't want to see blacks on TV, it's the same way some straight folks sound when they say, well, why are they everywhere? Feel like they're in everything. They in these Disney cartoons and shit now. Now they on commercials. Why they got to be on the Cheerio commercial? Why they got to be on Sesame Street? White folks was thinking the same thing. I don't want them in my neighborhood. Why they got to live over here? Same thing. There's so many parallels. But see, what happens is there's a crop of black people who don't want to hear that because they think that when we say that, when we draw those comparisons and those parallels, they hear us saying that being gay is just as difficult and just as challenging, you know, as it is, you know, as the traumas that black people went through. We're not saying that, you know, it's just as painful in terms of, you know, dogs being sent to you and water hydrants and all that kind of shit. We're not saying that. But the point is, it's all subjective. It's all subjective. And when I think about these quote unquote bloggers who, you know, and I'm not even famous, so I don't even know why they talk about me. But here's the thing. I'm not going to argue with you back and forth online. I'm just not. I have ways of getting in touch with you, and you'll just get a summons in the mail, bitch, because I'm not going to play with you, because you're not going to raise my stress level up arguing with you online and shit. I'm just not going to do it. All right, I'm not going to do it.
Let Vern.
But it's niggas like that. They the niggas that would have kept us from freedom.
Right.
They them self-hating niggas.
It said, Vern Smith said, Maddie, the context and tone you spoke in about her essay could be heard and seen as you went too far, only because you're better than that, in my opinion. Have you not learned going lower makes you look bad? Okay. Could be, but in the moment, you can't hit a person and tell them how to hit you back. That's never going to work.
Mm-hmm. And then over time, it just
gets, you get fed up with, you get fed with, up, you know, with it, yeah. People constantly doing this, you know, and I didn't. And what I didn't do was, yes, I didn't do anything any worse than when Kaya, the night we split up,
yeah,
got on her live and wore Monique out and everybody was over there like, oh, she read her. But there was no heat for it because the vitriol was coming from a woman to a woman. It's still back to the place of, well, she's a woman and you need to respect her traumas, and yours aren't as, your traumas that you have in your life are nowhere in equivalent to that.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
It's nowhere in equivalent to the things that she's been through. Right. So you don't have a right to say anything. You don't have a right to go in that direction. And I'm like, well, if you don't like me anymore because I went in there, here's the door.
Right.
You can leave, because what will never happen on God's earth is you will never hit me and tell me how to hit you back.
Mm.
It won't happen. It won't happen.
Right.
So it becomes, well, protect black women. Well, how do you protect black women that are attacking?
But then also, why aren't you saying that to these black women vloggers who are attacking other black women? Their entire platform is to tear down black women because they're on reality TV. What happened to protecting the mental piece, the mental capacity of black women? You don't think that these reality stars get tired of these bloggers talking about them, bullying them, cyberbullying them, posting them just because they want to check? And it's not even because they think that content is true. Their content isn't even satirical. So where are the white flags for that? They've built entire blogs tearing black people down.